Yeah, it's not, yes, as long as this goes passively and no one's dying, I agree. I think this favors not V. They just have better mid game, way better late game. Oh, here comes action.
Yep, there's the the arrow off the mark. Havos dodged it. Would have died for sure. Still going to end up being first blood. As Golblast
just a little bit, but still Funnik is leading the board here, 25-15. So
magic missile on Havos. Arrow going to be dodged again. Shot just a little late. Kuro eating a lot of damage right up front. But here comes Puppy and the Fury on ulti, helping to clear things up. Funnik teleports in. They're looking for another kill on the Golblast if they can find him. Not enough mana though for the Sprout, so he will eat one more ice blast and a couple of auto attack. Out he goes. Whenever the one missed, but that time definitely made a difference. Didn't he gonna be coiled in mid? And not enough mana for a Starfall or for an arrow. Dindy gonna be silenced out. Auto attacks, are they gonna be enough? Solo, jaunts underneath the tower.
Once again, Dindy again has that blink dagger ready to show it for the first time. It was on the way when they killed him before. Glad set on Havos, this should be a kill.
Sonoy lassoed back, here come the Visage Familiars to guarantee the stun. Arrow way off the mark, but able to bring him down. Fury on ulti just enough, and a little bit of see you later damage to 63. This will job on the Furion, split pushing bottom. While action happens here, we're gonna have Kuro caught with the coil, but only Kuro. AA blast on the way, and they managed to trade the Visage away. But spot out Havos moving into the Roche pit, saw it happening. That's gonna prompt the ulti. Now Golblast has to run. Dindy's right behind him. Lasso in 5 seconds. Blink is up if they want it. And here comes Funnik just to help secure things. Didn't have to spin the lasso. In the meantime, Sadoi's right behind it, but can't engage in the three. He's going to be spotted by Dindy, who lassos him back. That's a lot of creeps burning as well. Funnik right there with the auto attack damage, but Sadoi able to use the Timber Chain to get back to safety. Funnik, in the meantime, being pursued behind that by Solo. And it looks like Roxas will be able to clear their own jungle. I just heard a coil go off, actually. But Furion already level 11. As you mentioned, he's going to be having even more push power. Golblast's going to be spotted out by Dindy, and Most right there to follow it up, so easy kill for them. Furion ulti goes off just to help secure things. Behind that, we can see 633 could be in trouble. Dindy right on his tail. There's a Chilling Touch. He gives a little bit more damage. Chakram helps slow things down a little bit. Chilling Touch onto Yol. Soul Assumption enough to bring him down. Behind that, Sadoi has to back out. There's going to be another Ice Blast. And look at the damage that we're beginning to see out of that mix of magic plus physical damage. Behind the fight, they're not done. Dindy blinking and trying to find 633, and they didn't even need it.
Chance to catch it.
They're gonna move up, they need to get there very quickly. There we go, Havos spotted out, pops the ultimate, and there's the stun, who's gonna get it? Funnik managed to grab that, actually. And now they're gonna turn it around, and that just about might be that. So, Funnik able to grab the Aegis, coming in to help his teammate out, knowing that help was on the way from Roxas anyway. Now Sadoi spotted out. And we can already see a Dagon's actually been picked up by the Puck. Book 3 in the meantime, though. Done on the Prophet. Funnik shows back up. 3 stacks. There's the Sprout and the Firefly. A little bit extra damage, and down he goes. Yol was there to try to help. Solo there to help follow it up. So that's a nice kill to go ahead and grab the Aegis off of the Nature's Prophet. And let's see if he can get away. They may be able to follow this up. Puppy's coming to help, though. Coil will spin and only got him. Dindy going to be able to lasso Solo down. And there's the ultimate. That's going to get a bunch of bounces. And the follow-up from Funnik's own ultimate, Nature's Wrath. That's a quarter health bar for the two most farmed heroes on Roxas. We're going to see a coil spent to try and save Solo. And he may be able to jaunt away because of it. Yeah, he's going to be able to make it away even though most of Na'Vi was there.
Funnik, Solo kill onto Yol, perhaps.
Yep, going to be able to bring him down. However, there's a follow-up from Solo. Funnik getting a little bit greedy. And don't know that
20 kill in favor of Na'Vi.
Arrow will connect. That'll hit Kuro. But the number of creeps they got to push through just to come into these fights is massive. Here's an AA ultimate. This can sometimes extend games by itself with well-shot ultimates like that. To tell you the truth, I don't know if they care that much. Solo comes in. And gets a little bit of damage done. Na'Vi just gonna wait this out. There's the Moonlight Shadow. And the dust out from Puppies. He gets off the ultimate. Solo coming back in. Funnik's right there. They manage to sprout in the Mirana, forcing another leap. But Soul Assumption up to bring her down behind that. Just not enough damage. Sadoi wandering out. They're trying to bring down Funnik. And they will be able to follow it up with a Magic Missile from Golblast. Sadoi now on the high ground. And we'll be able to punish Kuro as well. Taking a lot of damage to do so. Golblast tried to get a swap off. And a buyback now from Funnik. Here comes the ultimate, and yeah, he basically just brought down the Ancient Apparition from half health with nothing but Nature's Wrath. Solo is quite low afterwards as well. And he's going to move on up, and they will be managed to bring down Dindy after he picks off Golblast. Funnik's right on his tail now, though. Has jaunt in a few seconds, not going to get a chance to use it as Funnik just a little too big too quick. And it's up, Provost just bringing down buildings, man, playing the one-man wrecking crew. Below that, a more split push now out of Funnik. I have no idea why that popped up because that is turned off.
Very aggressive lineup, especially in a try-on-try against the Lycan, that if they executed it, would have a ton of kills.